guys, so today we're going to look at putting together Sloshpipe for Mike. So we went and had some adventures this morning already trying to get the PVC. Schedule 44-inch PVC. Usually comes in 10-foot lengths. We got it cut down to 8 just so it's more manageable. A 10-footer, I have a 10-footer back here. It's kind of a pain. So we want something that people are going to be able to use and still be challenging at the same time. So what we did already was basically, so now we have a 4-inch diameter Schedule 40, 8-foot long piece. And then what we did was, for the sake of time, I capped one end with just a basic 4-inch end cap with PVC glue. And I'll show you how we will do the end on this side as we finish and fill it. But I wanted to get this set just so it would be pretty dry. What I do is you throw a ping pong ball in there to start to see. I want to try to get to about 2/3. And it's hard to tell with the black pipe especially. So we are naming this Katie, or Mike's girlfriend. So we're gonna throw that in there. As it starts to fill, the ping pong ball is gonna rise. If you put too much water in it, you're not gonna get much slosh. So we wanna make sure, like I said, about 2/3, a half to 2/3. You wanna make sure you have enough so that you got some load, but not too much, otherwise there's not going to be enough slosh. Right now I'm thinking might have a little bit too much. This might work, this will be good. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is make sure basically the ends are dry, and just be safe, and scuff up the end with a little bit of sandpaper. It's going to give us a little more grab with the PVC glue. I like to use a lot of glue. So basically make sure we get thorough. And don't inhale. Whew. And I put glue in the end cap as well. Lots and lots. Just to be safe. So now as I cap, maybe some air in there. It's gonna kind of force this cap down, so hopefully some of the air escapes, otherwise it creates kind of a pressure. There it is, man. Mike's got a new toy. Okay, so the final touch that we did, we just measured out, took exactly halfway down, and we put a marker there. And this is going to help you when you get set up, because it's really, if you're off an inch or two, it's really going to wreak havoc when you're trying to balance out. So I always suggest throwing, you know, just basically some paint tape on there, duct tape or something, just to give yourself a marker. Now you can line yourself up for all your exercises. Good work.
Cough it up loud and strong. The immigrants, they wanna sing all night long.